She looking good. She looking real good. She looking juicy, moisturized, and defined. Everyone, welcome back to your girl's channel. It's your girl, me, Charlene. Today, I'm going to show you guys how to get this super defined, moisturized wash and go.
Okay.
Please continue watching. So now we're going to get started. I'm going to start with my leave-in conditioner. And I'm just going to apply some of that right on top of my hair just to add a little bit of moisture to my hair because it did get a little dry. And I'm going to split that in half and I'm going to work in sections because that's my favorite thing to do. Now I'm going to moisturize the top. I like to always make sure that I'm getting my sections in between. Now you're going to mist your hair. Start off with a small amount of hair. Don't start off too much, especially if you're a beginner to this. Now I'm going to take my foam mousse, which is Nairobi foam mousse. I used to use this when I actually had a perm, but we don't do perms no more. I do it naturel. And I didn't know this is actually really good for your natural curls. I'm actually really ecstatic to be using this product again. Now I'm going to be taking my fave gel, my extreme hair gel, and I'm applying it to my roots like I used to do a perm when I had one. And I'm just going to rake that gel right through my curls. Okay, always make sure you do focus some more attention with the gel on the ends of your curls and then shingle it out. Do your praying hand method, do your finger curl method, whatever works for you, do that. But I'm taking small sections of my curls and I'm just like pulling it apart wherever my curls naturally want to go. That's basically what I'm doing. Also, with the foam mousse that I did use, you can actually use that for a twist out, you can use it for a braid out, you can use it for a wash and go as you see me using it for. You can even use it, girl, if you still got your sleek Halle Berry perm look, bitch, girl, use that as well. The foam mousse works pretty much like, it's like a multi-use product. Like, you can use it, like, for so many different hairstyles. It's, like, amazing. Now, I'm really going to emphasize that the only reason why you guys see me not struggling so much in this specific wash and go video tutorial I'm giving y'all is not just because of the foam mousse. It's not just because of the products that I use. It's because your girl went and took it upon herself to get her hair professionally shaped, which included a trim. My curls were horrible. They were constantly getting tangled. I felt like the products didn't penetrate my hair enough. Whatever homegirl did, she hooks this up. And now I'm just feeling so much more confident in my wash and goes. Like, what? Can't tell me nothing. Like, you could probably tell me something, but you can't tell me nothing if you get me. You get my drift, right? But honestly, now that I'm doing my go-to styles, I love wash and goes. I just couldn't wear them as much because my ends were horrible. They were like literally in shambles. But like I said, since I got in a trim, my wash and goes have been pretty easy for me. I love it. Now, when it comes to me styling my hair, I guess I'm just going to recap, you know, just to make sure you guys didn't forget any important parts. You want to definitely make sure you have your hair wet. Okay, wet. Listen, if the top part got wet, you better moisturize that bottom, okay, and rub it in. Like, make sure all the strands are getting love, okay? Don't be like missing somebody. Don't do that. Don't show favorites. Like, everybody should be your favorite. Every strand should be your favorite. Now, with the foam mousse, the way you want to apply it, you want to apply a small amount, and you want to make sure that you're getting that foam mousse right on the root. Like, if you avoid the root, sweetheart, like, you're really not paying attention to this video. You're really not paying attention. Get the root, and you want to keep, how would I say, you want to keep making sure the foam mousse is applied throughout the whole amount of hair that you're using, that you're playing with. And now I'm just going to take my brush and I'm going to detangle my hair with this brush. Now, if you see right now, I have to make sure that my whole hair strands are smooth. If they're not smooth and I come across any knots or tangles, I literally use my fingers to softly and gently detangle those ends because I'm not trying to experience a lot of loose strand knots. I always experience those. So I'm trying to this time around make sure I do take more proper care when it comes to detangling my hair. So I'm applying my extreme gel, and I really like this gel because it has a strong hold for my type 4A curls, and it definitely helps me achieve a longer lasting wash and go. So when using this gel, how I like to apply it, I like to apply a good amount at the root because I need my roots to be frozen. Like, I need them to not freeze whatsoever. And then I start to obviously apply more at the bottom just to keep that curl definition nice and strong. And then I apply the rest of the amount throughout my mid shaft. Now, what I like to do the shingling method because I find out by doing this method, my curls just kind of like go the way they want to, and I get a better results when it comes to me drying my hair afterwards. So that is all for this video today, folks. I hope you guys enjoyed the results. If you did, leave me a big thumbs up. Leave your comment on the products I used today in the comment box below. Don't neglect your trims, ladies, and I'll see you all again in my next video. Ciao!